Hello, I'm Steve Lockett, one of the Angler's Mail Tackle Test team. Coming free with the 10th of July issue of the UK's most exciting weekly read, you can get either a flatbed method feeder or a flatbed pellet feeder. Also, inside that same issue is an action replay feature at Somerset's Viaduct Fishery, where I give you a great look at how to use your fabulous free gift. The feature covers most aspects of fishing with these brilliant feeders, but here are a couple of extra tips to make sure you have a cracking day when you first try them. When you're driving the fish wild with your feed, you can get plagued by line bites, constant little taps or really slow, long pulls on the tip and then it will spring back. This is caused by the fish milling around close to the feeder and hitting the main line. If the fishery rules allow it, just try pinching an SSG shot about 30 centimetres away from the feeder. Now when you cast out, tighten the line up very slowly, but don't put any bend in the tip at all. Now the main line, that crucial area next to the feeder, be pinned down tight on the bottom and the fish won't be hitting the line, so you'll only see proper bites. If the feeder's being knocked around by smaller fish, you'll see lots of little rattles on the tip. What I like to do is just take a strip of lead off of an open end feeder and wrap it onto the method feeder. This way it'll achieve two things. It will hold the feeder dead still in your swim, but it'll also improve the self-hooking capabilities of the rig. Now keep watching, because I'm going to run through how to mix up some ground bait and prepare damp and micro pellets for using for your new free piece of kit. Here's the kit I use to mix ground bait and dampened micros for the method feeder. A bait box of water, bag of micro pellets and ground bait mix, a shallow bowl, a deep bucket and a riddle. First, empty some dry ground bait into the bucket and slowly add water. Whisk the water in with your fingers and break up any large lumps that form. Remember to only add water a little at a time so you don't overwet it. You can always add more water later. When it's close to the correct consistency, pour it into the shallow bowl. Now put the riddle onto the bucket and shake the mix through. Push through any large lumps that are left as they contain vital extra moisture. You should be left with a mix which easily forms a ball, but can be broken down again very quickly. You don't want a stodgy mix. Now put your pellets into the shallow bowl and add water to just cover them. Give them a stir to make sure they're all wet and simply leave them to absorb all of the water. There's no need to time them, they're much easier to use if they're very damp. You can squeeze them hard on the feeder, but they'll still break down fast when they're in the swim. I keep both ground bait and micros together in the same bowl so that I can try either one on the feeder or even a mix of both.